Hello, welcome to my channel Surbhi, and these are the readings for you for the second half of October, and they're all general readings. It may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you're dealing with, or they may be the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to the situation as they resonate with you. And if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign as well as the sign from which your name sign, according to the first alphabet of your name. And if you want to get a personal reading, then the details are given in the description box below. So coming to your reading, Taurians, you have been, I don't know, I'm laughing or smiling, whatever it is, because all the readings I'm doing today are getting a contrast of the energies. Contrast of energies, depressed and too happy. One side is too depressed and betrayed, other side is too happy. Anyway, it's good that if people become happy this month. Anyway, so with the Three of Swords, you feel you've been betrayed. You have a very painful situation about which you are not able to heal yourself. And because there was a tower moment, and which is all about maybe something literally came crashing down, actually financially, in your status, in your relationship or whatever. In your friendship, it can be different for different people. But yes, there has definitely been some situation in your life which has left you devastated, and you are very feeling very bad about it, and you are holding that pain in your heart, and it feels as if literally you are not able to come out of it. Okay, I'm being drawn to this, I don't know why, for the first time I'm being drawn to this sort of a rain or the shine which is coming from the heavens through this heart. Okay, I was instantly drawn, and over here I can see a little pinkish color also. I'm being drawn to this card this way for the first time, which I feel is a very good sign. That means that the universe or the sky, the angels above, or God is giving you that healing energy. Okay, you will be healed. It is the protective energy or the healing energy or something which was destined to happen, so that you learn what something, or a lesson which was really supposed to be learned. You are in a confused state with the Five of Wands, or there is an actual argument or a conflict happening in your surroundings with somebody. Okay, so either you are confused about the situation as to what to do, what not to do, and with the Seven of Pentacles, you are looking at your assets and whatever you had, or if you're feeling nostalgic about it, or you're just looking at them and you really don't know what to do about them. Okay, you're not very happy, you don't seem to be very happy looking at them. Okay, maybe you are just feeling nostalgic as to how much you've worked hard, or you are just feeling nostalgic because you don't have this right now. It can be different for different people. There is definitely something which you are confused about and you are nostalgic about. Not really, it doesn't give me a very positive or a happy vibe. Why? Because see, then you have the Hangman also. Hangman is, again, you are in a situation you are confused about, you feel very bad and devastated and a painful energy, and you're not able to reap the benefits perhaps of whatever it is you have accumulated. Maybe you're not able to use that, just looking at it from far, I don't know, can be different. You're in a Hangman energy, you really don't know what to do. You're not able to move forward in a situation. You are just tied up, and literally there is nothing you can do about it. You are in such an energy. But with the Eight of Wands, things will improve. You will get the signals, you will get the communication, you will get the support, you will know what to do and how to move forward, because the universe will help you. That is what I am saying. So you will get some sort of a support, or some sort of, be in touch with your own self, be in touch with your insight, so that you get the answers, or you're able to see this. See, don't be depressed, that is what I am trying to say, because if somebody offers you some sort of support, if you don't miss an opportunity, at least you should be in that frame of mind that you are able to see the opportunity or understand what other person is trying to say, or see what universe is giving the signals to come out of the situation, and if any other opportunity or any other healing is there, because something is definitely coming in the form of a text. Now it can be an actual communication, it can be a text. Some opportunity will come through it which will give you happiness with the Ten of Cups. And with the Queen of Cups, you again are attaining that sort of an I should say that energy, or that authoritative position, and you have that cup in your hand. You're again contemplating and again looking at that cup with the with the feeling as to how much you have achieved and how much you have toiled to get that position once again. So the guidance over here is, don't be too depressed, come out of this energy and just be in touch with people around you. Maybe you need a lot of support, maybe somebody will give you a good advice, maybe you literally get an opportunity through a mail, some friend, some relative, some suggestion, or just be in touch with the surroundings. Don't isolate yourself. You will definitely get some signal or some communication, so that you will be able to come out of it and you will get an opportunity. Now with the Two of Hearts, it is all about contemplation and it is about temperance and moderation. So you need to, that is what I am saying, come out of this energy so that you are able to see the opportunities which will be given to you. You need to exert balance in your life as for now. That is the only guidance which you need. And with this Emperor card, it is about wisdom, experience and authority. So you have the wisdom, you know what is you are supposed to do, you have the authority or will soon have the authority. So it is not that you don't know how to go ahead, you know how to create things once again, you know how to make things happen, and you will soon be in that energy either, or you will be utilizing that wisdom and authority of yours to recreate the things which maybe you have lost because of something. Three of Thought, loving angels surround you to heal and comfort you. The sadness you feel will fade away with time, and then you will be able to see clearly how important this situation has been for your spiritual growth. Take the time you need to forgive yourself and others so that you can embrace the future with joy. So that is what I am also saying. See, you need to heal and come out of the situation, because obviously it will fade away with time. Everything will be okay. You are getting some sort of an opportunity through the universe, but you will later realize as to whatever happened was made to it will make you grow yourself from within, so that you are able to understand as to why it happened and it really needed to happen. Okay, and you will learn some good lesson out of it. Okay, so number three may be of some significance for you. Back to where you love, reevaluate your desires. So whatever you are now, wherever you are right now, you should go back to, don't be depressed. Go back to the place in your mind as to where you were. Maybe this is what you are being nostalgic about. You are feeling, you're looking at what you really had at one time. And maybe with the Queen of Cups also, she's also doing the same. Okay, just looking to what you had or what you really cherished and how much you toiled. So go back to that space, go back to that energy when you felt loved and when you were in a loving energy, and try to think from that point of view, and then you will be able to reevaluate what you really want as for now in life. So that if you are, what really made you happy, what are the things which really made you happy once upon a time, and at least try to go recreate them and do what you feel is right for you. Okay, because if you are in a positive space of mind, only then you will be able to take the right decision. Because if you are in a loving energy, if you are in a happy energy, just see the trust with this maiden is moving ahead. At the end of the tunnel, there is a divine guidance over there, and all the butterflies and all the doves, they are just following her, or they are moving ahead of her rather, to show her that colorful path. So this is the trust with which you need to go back. She is going back to the point of love, so that she is able to reevaluate and rethink as to what makes her happy. That is what you are supposed to do. Try to rethink and reevaluate your desires. What went wrong? Why it went wrong? Analyze it, understand it and move ahead. Okay, and as far as your personal relationships are concerned, maybe if you have suffered a heartbreak in the relationship, if you feel something has gone wrong, and if you think that you have not done anything wrong, still there must be something which this so-called relationship or a friendship has taught you. That is what you need to understand, and for that, stop blaming the other person, forgive the other person, forgive yourself, don't be too hard on yourself, and try to reevaluate what you actually wanted and what you expected from the person, what the other person expected from you, and reevaluate your desires and expectations, and as understand how to move forward properly in future. Okay, so that's all I have for you, and please like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.